message to Narendra Modi and his Indian government that he is not welcome in Scotland.
We've all gathered here from Scotland and from across the UK to protest about the arrival of Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of India, for COP26, because there's huge outstanding humanitarian issues that remain unanswered and unresolved, and particularly justice for 1984 and the Sikh genocide. The Indian government, led by Indira Gandhi, supported by Margaret Thatcher, sent the Indian army with tanks, helicopter gunships, artillery to the most sacred shrine, the Golden Temple in Amritsar, and they bombed it and destroyed it and killed tens of thousands of pilgrims. It's akin to the Italian government sending the military into the Vatican on Easter. 4 months later, following the assassination of Indira Gandhi, the Congress government and BJP leaders orchestrated a mass genocide where thousands and thousands of Sikhs were slaughtered on the streets of Delhi. No one has been brought to justice for those crimes. And that strategy against the Sikhs has continued. It's been targeting Sikhs as extremists and as fanatics and fundamentals and terrorists since 1984.
Months we've been sleeping out and demonstrating in solidarity with the farmers that are standing on the Delhi border streets for their human rights.
They are protesting in their millions. It is the largest protest in human history for the same civil rights that the movement in 1984 started, for Sikhs to have their own equality, their religious recognition, their own water, their own farming rights. They have been beaten by the police with over 800 deaths. They're being killed on the streets for the profit of multi-million pound corporations.
During the COVID crisis, the Indian government put three farming bills through and didn't even tell the farmers about it. First one takes away the minimum wage. It gets rid of the minimum support price. The second bill gets rid of their right to take any matter that they have to a court, and then you get rid of the mandis, the middlemen who protect your minimum support price. And the corporates say, oh, we'll give you a higher price, don't worry. But 2-3 years later, just like has happened in Bihar state, the price drops. 50% of India, nearly 700 million people, will go into grave poverty. Not like they're not in poverty already, but we're talking serious suffering here.
When we talk about agriculture and natural produce and organic produce, which is what the farmers of Punjab have done for generations, they are actually polluting that with pesticides, with steroids, to get mass production out, because it's all about the dollar.
Thursday morning, women in their 50s and 60s were sat on the streets in Dikri border. They had all their bags packed. They'd just finished making the food for the langar, the community kitchen, for the people, the poor people there, and the protest. A big truck, as it gets near to the women, starts speeding. Three of the women died right there, and the other three are in critical condition.
Steel rods have been drilled into the roads overnight so they would stop protesters and kill them. And those police officers and those workmen are being fed by the farmers. They are being invited into the camps and saying, here, eat, share with us. The government of India was sending messages out for everyone to stay out of the affairs of India. It's like, we can kill and we can slaughter and we can murder at will.
If we're talking about the real terrorists, it's Modi and his fascist government.
Modi is part of the BJP party, which has a paramilitary wing called the RSS. Adolf Hitler was inspired by the RSS. They believe that their Hindutva are supreme. So Modi is this god that they've raised on this platform, and he is obviously going to bring this Hindutva Raj, this kingdom.
He was banned from entry to this country for 10 years for his role in the Gujarat genocide, 2002, until he became Prime Minister of India.
They have demolished a mosque, a historical mosque, and they created a mandir, a temple, a Hindu temple. A few days ago, they've been burning Muslim people's buildings.
Priti Patel, the current Home Secretary, has well-documented links to the RSS, is backed and funded by the RSS, as are other politicians of Indian origin. Look at the Conservative Friends of India, and who are they funded by and backed by? It just gives you the absolute shock that the foreign government have such influence and such interference in our policy making and decision making and government at the highest levels.
Free Jaggi now!
Free Jaggi now!
Free Dougie now!
Free Dougie now!
Jack Tar is a Scottish born and bred national. He went to India in October 2017 to get married. He got married on the 18th of October. 4th of November, he was out shopping with his wife and his car was stopped. He was bungled, hooded, and taken away by plain clothed people. We didn't know they were police officers. He was then subjected for 4 days of third degree torture. When we talk about torture, I'm talking about him being electrocuted to his private parts, his sensitive parts, having a petrol can put in front of him and told that we will burn you alive. My brother used to document on the attack on the Golden Temple in 1984. He was a human rights activist. The Indian government did not like that fact. The Chief Minister of Punjab at the time accused him of various murders. 4 years on, he's not been formally charged on any of those allegations. He's faced over 230 hearings and not 1 ounce of evidence came against him. The murders that he's accused of being involved in happened whilst he was in the UK. He's innocent.
The way in which the present UK government treats detention abroad is a scandal. The lack of support has been profoundly disturbing.
The latest Foreign Secretary, Dominic Raab, has refused to meet, and most recently, Liz Truss has also refused to meet. It took Nicola Sturgeon over 3 years before she met with me.
A trade deal is getting in the way of the British government standing up for a son of the rock, Jagtar Singh Johal. Their demands for lower tariffs, their demands for liberal politics and liberal trade is holding up justice for Jagtar Singh Johal.
All we are demanding is a right to a free trial, and if they can't give it, let them go.
We've seen that with the Home Secretary sign off extradition orders for 3 British-born young professionals without a shred of evidence.
The Indian government sought their extradition to India to subject them to the similar treatment as to my brother.
The day after Dominic Raab met the foreign counterpart in India, the day after, this was in December 2020, he came back, had a little chat with Preeti Patel. The day after that meeting, the trade deal meeting, Preeti Patel signed an extradition request after more than 10 years of those West Midlands 3 being found innocent.
That's what the UK government want to partner with and announce economic deals, trade deals and climate deals with. The effects of climate change in India are catastrophic, from a lack of water in the Himalayas, which then flows down to the northern states of Punjab. And we're seeing the land of five rivers, what Punjab stands for, rivers going dry. The water belt and the water table in Punjab is at dangerous levels. The uranium levels in the water of Punjab and surrounding states is at cancerous levels. The pesticides, the chemicals that are being injected into foods and sprayed across crops is causing huge amount of cancer rates in India.
No country in the world has the courage to tell Narendra Modi, you need to do something about the coal, the level of coal that you are using in India. The air pollution in Delhi and Mumbai alone is killing people.
And that's the leader who's been welcomed here at COP26 in Glasgow today. The farmers' protest, it's an absolute beacon for the world. If everyone gets together, we can real drive, real change that will change the world, not only for humanity, but the world will save our earth for generations to come.